If we want to compare two arrays, we got to loop through and compare the positions one at a time. So with strings, remember they are an array. So if we wanted to compare this one to this one, they're the same. We go to the next one. So for example, you could have like a for loop that goes the length of the entire string. So the string has a count of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So as long as we're less than 5, we're good. So at the 0 spot, they're the same. The 1 spot, they're the same. The 2 spot, they're the same. 3 spot, they're not the same. So that's where it breaks out. It says, hey, this is false. Now if we happen to change one of these, then we continue on, and they turn out the same, and then we return it true. So it could return a false or a true. With the strings, they have a function, but it's a little bit different. It actually does calculations on them, so it calculates the overall size and all that. And it handles everything for you, but the result is a zero if it's true, and everything else is false, which is kind of confusing because generally we'll see a zero is false, and then everything else is true. So it's kind of the opposite. But it's still a very useful function that you can use, and we'll take a look at that right now. Now, to use these string comparisons without doing for loops and all that, you need to include the string.h. So I'm going to go ahead and include, I need a, it's a standard library, so string.h. So it's not a library that you've created, it's a library that's created in General C. I include this code that has all these extra functions. Now in my main function, I'm just going to do some testing. So I'm going to create a character string, so char, and let's call it name. I'm going to say it has a max of 20 characters. So this doesn't say exactly how many characters it is, it just says that I'm allotting 20 spaces for characters. I'm going to put it equal to my name. I probably want to put quotes around it. Alright, now if I want to compare two strings, I can do a strn, and you see there's this function that returns an int. So let's go ahead and store this value. So int result equals strn compare, and I'll say apple, and then the how many spaces of memory you want to check. And I want to printf that result. Printfs are percent %d for ints. If I run this, you'll notice I get a number. If I change this where it says apple, if I change it to what my name is and run it, I get a zero. So this is a function that returns a zero if the strings are the same. So if this string is equal to this string, it's going to return a zero. Also return something else. So if we wanted to put this in an if statement, I would go ahead and take out the int result. I'm going to say if string compare double equals. So we don't want to do one single equal because that'd set it. And I'm going to go ahead and printf. We have a match. Else, printf, we don't have a match. Okay, so if I run this, we have a match. If I change it just slightly, so if I just take one letter off, we don't have a match. So this is how you can check strings. Now you don't have to get it from right here. It doesn't have to be a static one. You can actually get them from these argvs as well.